got back from Seattle yesterday. Just got back from summer school. Glad to get that over with. And just got your tape, too. It's good, because I was wondering what had happened to you. Sounds like you aren't in the best of spirits these days. You're just, I don't know, kind of up and down about things. Sound like you're kind of bumming out about the prospect of another semester of school, which I guess you guys will be starting pretty soon. School doesn't start here for another few weeks. My folks want me to get a job until then, but fuck that. Don't think that's gonna happen. Only thing I feel like doing is, I was thinking maybe if you wanted to blow off school or something, you could come up here for a while and hang out. It's pretty nice up here. It's good hiking weather. Could maybe, there's a big concrete M up on the side of the mountain. Maybe we could hike up there or something. I'll probably spend some time with Linda, but I don't know. I got a roommate who's he's up for doing anything, just about anything. He's into hanging out. Linda has a friend too. Maybe we can all do something together. I don't know. Maybe she just go to school.
How long do you think it'll be?
The time.
Thank you. of the law. 5 cigars and 4 cigarettes are permitted, all in private accommodation. We ask our passengers to allow non-smoking areas to convenience of the public transport systems. For your safety, please do not take a cigarette in the vestibule area between cars, as this may pose a fire. We also ask that you not move from car to car with private cigarettes. We choose to require all time while viewing about the train. We also ask for parents of small children not to leave them unattended, especially near the center stairway or the indoor to each car. We also ask that you please do not open the lower vestibule doors or windows at any time. For your convenience, each coach has a trash receptacle at either end and one in the center of each car. Toilets are located on the lower level of all coaches and fleet.
About 30, Tom.
There's a 3 6 call. That's a 12 o'clock tonight.
12:30.
Well, it's 12 o'clock now, so.
that was to Williamston.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I got there, so.
How are things going in Austin?
Oh, you know, same old shit.
Parents pissed because you weren't going to school?
Yeah, they're pissed, but I hadn't really told them yet.
Yeah.
Guess I'll send them a postcard or something like that. Doubt they're too worried about anything.
Anything particular you want to do in Missoula?
No, not really. What is going on? What is going on?
I don't know. I guess we could rent some movies. It's kind of nice out. We could, we could do something outside.
Any shot of us getting up to Glacier like you mentioned?
Actually, yeah, if we could, scan my girlfriend's car off of her. I don't think she'd be going to go in too much herself, but she doesn't really like to hike or anything.
And that friend of hers you mentioned?
Yeah, we might be able to get her to drive up there with us.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where are we going?
Double Pro.
What's that?
Chicken place.
Chicken?
Well, they got like a bar underneath.
Oh.
You know, get all the food there.
What's
their dude? Well, it's Turkey photography. We can get, something to eat downstairs, you know, and, and then maybe go out to the top half,
Hey,
you
that's big mountains.
Which one do you have? You have nice hair.
You have mountains,
and you have loops. That's all you have.
That's a lot of people out.
So you have to take that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Let me check this out. This guy just, he just met, yeah, he's just got through reading the Metamorphosis, right? And he meets Kafka, and they're talking about writing and everything, and he says, and the author says to Kafka, he's just talking about writing, the way he writes. He says, "I am disturbed by the light, the factory, the houses, the windows over the way, most of all by the light. The light distracts my attention." And then Kafka says, "Perhaps it distracts one from the darkness within. It is good when the light overpowers one. If it were not for these horrible sleepless nights, I would never write at all. But they always recall me again to my own dark solitude." And the author says, "Is he not himself the unfortunate bug?" The unfortunate bug.
The unfortunate bug.
It is. Missoula Valley.
I'm gonna do this. Climb up here.
Gotta do something.
Nearly like, but this is Holland Lake.
Is that where the swing is? Are you sure? How you know?
I know.
Boom. Thank you.
Yeah, that's exactly what I wanted.
Yeah, Pops, you could take care of a whole room full of people with that gun. They may not kill them all, but then they wouldn't be good for anything afterwards.
I know you'd take care of it for me, Nicky. Say, how long you had this place?
Almost a year.
Yeah, it's picturesque enough, but there can't be much profit in it.
There isn't. But then there isn't much trouble in it either. What are you thinking about?
A job. Your kind of a job. A job with a rifle.
What kind of money, Pops?
$5,000.
Who'd have had to kill?
Нельзя, нельзя, научиться,
научиться,
пахать,
пахать,
нет, пахать,
пахать,
читая,
читая,
книги,
книги.
Нельзя научиться пахать, читая книги.
Нельзя, пахать,
пахать,
пахать, читая,
читая, книги,
книги.
Очень хорошо.
Нельзя.
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 Научиться.
Научиться.
Пахать.
Пахать.
Читая.
Читая.
Книги.
Книги.
Очень хорошо.
Нельзя.
Be sure to tell Linda thanks for letting us use your car.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's pretty nice. Save a few bucks, save the terminal, the metal terminal cause of us sitting along the road there.
Nice, yeah. Yeah, nice.
Okay, so you like all of the people, but what did the story mean to you?
Well, it means a lot.
Well, then tell me what it's all about.
Then don't get mad. Every time I open my mouth, you get mad at me.
You don't understand a word of what I said. You don't understand the story at all.
No, I don't, but that don't mean I don't like it. I don't understand you neither, but that don't mean I don't like you. I love you. But I don't understand you. What's the matter with that?
Jenny?
What?
Will you marry me?
What?
Marry me, now, tonight.
Much?
Yes, sir.
Dear Frank,
I presume you're in the midst of a hectic preparation for your last big autumn term! Exclamation point.
Hey.
Hopefully you will enjoy the cool weather before winter sets in. You are glad, in a sense, I suspect, that you managed to miss the Texas summer this year. And what a summer it has been! Exclamation point. The garden is very dry right now, and Hans, Bernini, and Wooly are spending most of the day in the shade. Enclosed is your autumn tuition money. Thank you very much.
Cool.
I put in a little bonus for a new winter coat and some wool socks, which I'm sure you will need.
Your money.
Naturally, since we haven't seen you in quite some time, we want you to come home Christmas. Therefore, we would like to know your final schedule as soon as possible so that we can make you a plane reservation.
Your bus leaving?
Not for a couple hours, but I gotta get back over to Frank's and my stuff together, you know, ready to go on. Bags and shit.
You need a ride to the station or anything?
I don't think so. I think we're just gonna walk over there, you know. It's not too far or anything.
Alright.
Well. See you later.
Okay. attention, please. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to load by destination this evening. We don't want you to get in the wrong section of the train. We're now going to board our coach passengers, and first, we'll board passengers for Minot, Williston, Havre, Whitefish, Spokane, Pasco, Wishram, Big White Salmon, Vancouver, and Portland, Oregon.
Good morning, may I have attention, please? This is Robert E. Temple in charge, the lower cafe, the bar. I'm now open to serve cocktail, wine, beer, soda, snacks, hot and cold sandwich, and so on. Please come down for a visit. Thank you.
Choice of coffee, hot or iced tea, or milk as a beverage. We also have an a la carte selection, including apple and cherry pie for desserts, cheesecake and carrot cake, vanilla ice cream, as well as beer, light wine, Coca-Cola, or 7-Up to accompany your meal, at a slight additional charge. Once again, this will begin about noon today in the dining. Thank you.
How big are those egg rolls?
Oh, about that
week. Okay, egg roll and a
2 o'clock in the fucking morning. Just got back from my favorite restaurant in the world. Doing my favorite job in the world. Washing fucking dishes. Big pain in the ass. That restaurant I was telling you about. Found out today that this other dishwasher that I work with has been in this fucking dish room since 1962. God, 1962. He's been Joe Dish ever since. His whole lot in life.
I'm in town for a little while.
Yeah. I'm over at my sister's right now. I just got in. But, So, how are things? Cool. Well, actually, I'm kind of on my way to Huntsville after this. My mom and her boyfriend are going out of town. Like, she just had a dog that had puppies and all this stuff and needs someone to take care of them. So, I guess I kind of got volunteered. But, So what are you up to later this afternoon? Yeah, I can cruise by. Well, first I gotta, my dad's in town. We're having a big, I have to go over to my grandmother's. There's some big, some kind of tribal obligation. I think we're getting together for some reason. So, I gotta go over there for a while, but then I can probably cruise over after that. I'll try to get out of there pretty quick, if I can. And, so maybe I'll be over later, huh? Okay, I kinda gotta get going now, because I was supposed to be over there already. So. Okay.
Hey, Grandma. Yeah, I'm here. Is everybody here?
Okay. Go ahead and let me in. Yeah. Okay, bye.
Where was I tell you where you used to smell garlic? In Chicago. You get on a crowded streetcar going to work in the morning.
Oh, yeah.
In the morning?
Oh,
yes. Get on the, in the
and
elevator.
And you have all these foreigners and the garlic.
That's the rest. I guess. But haven't you found them in the elevators at school? I guess you don't.
I have one story school.
To yeah.
You've got to work in an ethnic neighborhood.
Yeah.
Different flavors.
Maybe their clothes were just the cinnamon.
This is bad bread. This is garlic. They've been eating garlic.
Well, you know, Italians have very low heart disease. I think it's the garlic and the olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
And
a lifestyle.
Yeah.
I don't give a rip.
Mm-hmm.
Attitude.
Yeah.
That'll do it.
Well, it's not so much I don't give a rip, but I don't have any need to give a rip. It's, you know, they don't.
But they have their priorities
ordered. Right,
they know.
That's it, yeah.
They know what's important.
A little bit.
I'm not doing what they might do.
Credit wants to be the most humane people that have a real sense of what's
social community. Like Ireland and
the
they don't sit at the house and drink. They go down to the bar.
I've read
especially if you're on your side.
Anything white in my house is.
You don't want your blank protected.
No, that's
even colored things like quite often, but I've worn
Hickory, Bark Hard, and Snot. Friday,
I'll try to share with you some of the very talk of that. I can in Southwest Freeway is pretty much.
On his first album, and I understand he's quite an artist.
The fair was called into a special meeting in The Hague yesterday and told that.
Oh, there's no time. telling what impact, if any, that could have on various aspects of a 1,300-page farm bill.
Are you out of your mind?
I must have been.
Hey, can you use an extra hand, Mac?
Are you kidding?
You can play the little left to right,
honey sack down the left hand side there.
Can't play bocce ball.
Because whether you're just starting out or you've started a family all.
Fine.
Be still.
You are the renowned Gregor the Great.
Be quiet.
And not Edgar realizes that.
Tomato.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
I guess you do. She wouldn't be the reason you sold the label up, would she?
Could be.
Look, David, it ain't none of my business, but fishermen, smart fishermen, don't go chasing yachts abroad, especially if they're married.
And who says they're married?
Well, aren't they?
Seahawks will go home a happy crew. They're 7-6. The Cowboys season possibly over. Also now 7-6. And in a game that may have as many repercussions for next year as it does for the rest of this season.
Thanks for watching the house while we're gone.
Yeah, sure.
Everything going okay with you?
Yeah.
I have a good trip. Be careful.
Thank you.
Hvem er du egentlig?
Jeg er mange forskellige.
Hvem?
Jeg er morgentuggen, der drypper fra træernes blade. Og den hvide sky, der sejler. Ingen ved, hvorhen.
Hvad mere?
Jeg er månen. Jeg er himlen.
Er du mere?
Ja. Jeg er en mund. En mund, der søger en anden mund.
Det lyder som i en drøm.
Det er en drøm. Livet er en drøm.
Livet?
Ja. Livet er en lang, lang kæde af drømme, der glider over i hinanden.
Og munden, du talte om?
En drøm.
Og munden, du søgte?
Også en drøm.
Hey, what does your shirt say? What does that shirt say?
It's Russian. I can't really pronounce it, but it means in Russian, you can't learn to plow by reading books. Old Russian.
Oh, what's that book? What's that book?
Yes, I can't remember. The Burning Brand. Diaries from this crazy guy.
Here's one of my tapes. You can have
your tapes?
Yeah. Some songs.
Really?
I can record things. Yeah. I'm recording right now.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I hope you like it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Take it easy. Yeah. Yeah.
Anymore, and I don't feel much like living. Can't
machine and just lay there on my bed, and I just started talking to the machine, and I never felt that. Usually I'm real self-conscious about recording my voice in the machine, and I don't, I don't like this, let me stop. But I did it, and it all came out. It's like it all needed to come out. It's like an hour and a half, or however long the cassette was, both sides. And like I was interrupted a couple of times with someone knocking at the door or whatever. But it was all on the tape, And then when it was over, I decided to listen to it. And I listened to it and I said, God, all these horrible things that are happening to that woman and that the poor little girl, you know, just so much. She's so strong for herself. She's talking to this machine. She's here alone in this house, talking to this machine, telling it, all her problems, and it's so sad. So while it was still on, I could hear my voice, and I'm talking about my problems and everything. I just got so sad, I started crying. This poor girl, she's going through so much. How could she do it? It's too much to happen to one person in one lifetime, let alone in 2 or 3 weeks. And she shouldn't be alone right now. She should be with someone else. And so
I can't feel you anymore. I can't even touch the books you've read. Every time I crawl past your door, I've been wishing I was somebody else instead. Down the highway, down the tracks, down the road to ecstasy, I waited for you. Hounded by your memory and all your